First to take to the courts to battle for gold, representing Team China, please welcome Yu Heiyi. Xu Yingbin. And Xiao Ping. Please welcome to the court, Team China. Yu Yingbin. And Xiao Ping. Representing Team Japan, please welcome Yuta Tanaka. Yukiya Ura. And Shunsuke Togami. Representing Team China, please welcome Yu Heiyi. Zhu Yinbin and Xiao Peng. Please put your hands together one more time for all of the competitors.
So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this boys' teams. Currently, China 13, Japan 2, rest of the world 0. We're back here again, and with me in the commentary, we are delighted to have the number one ranked junior player in the world, Kanak Jha. Welcome, Kanak.
Thank you. I look forward to a really good match. China and Japan have always been the best countries in the world, especially in the junior level, and I think it'll be a really exciting finals now.
I think it certainly will. And the first match here between Yuta Tanaka from Japan and Yu Heiyi from China. I mean, the Chinese team in general, just classic, close to the table, fast players. What does Japan need to do in this team's match, do you think, to try to arrest the might of this Chinese team?
I think Japan, they really have to be good over the table, especially with the service serve return, because it's really hard to beat the Chinese once they get comfortable in the mats and once they're allowed to attack in the first openings of the rally, because they have so much power and so much speed, and they also can place the ball really anywhere on the table. So I think for Tanaka and the rest of the Japanese to have a chance, they need to be really strong on the receive game and try to get the first attack when possible.
Indeed. So on screen there, the far end in the red shirt, Yu Heiyi, 18 years of age, right-hand attacking player, and in yellow, representing Japan, Yuta Tanaka, also 18 years of age, also a right-hand attacking player, currently ranked 56 in the world, but I think that's sometimes these junior rankings are a little bit topsy-turvy, aren't they? Except for the number one, though, Kanak.
Yeah, definitely. I think with the new system, the ranking, you have to play many tournaments to have a high ranking. And oftentimes, especially when you're very strong in the junior level, you're playing more senior tournaments. And this causes your junior ranking to sometimes drop, even though you're a very strong, probably one of the best juniors in the world.
So the players just doing their final preparations. Players getting 2 minutes to warm up before a match. So now moving to the backhand side. So what's the etiquette here with the warm-up, Karnak?
Yeah, so normally it's 2 minute warm-up where both players will each loop a few balls backhand and forehand while the other blocks and the other will loop. And then normally after 2 minutes, maybe a little earlier, when they feel ready, they say it's okay and they start the match. Now you can see UAE is looping, then after Tanaka, and then they will start.
And what are they trying to do? I mean, they're not trying to learn new strokes here, right? So what are they trying to do in this 2 minutes?
I think just a little bit warm up the body. Of course, it's always a little hard to start in the beginning of the match to be fully warm. So this is just like a little mini warm up to just make them in top shape. And also, I think a little mentally to get ready. It's always a little different standing on the table versus outside mentally. So this helps.
So players now completing their warm-up and ready to play. So China serving first, Yu serving. Lovell. So Tanaka there firing up. Winning the first point.
Yeah.
That's that over the table ball that you're talking about there.
Yeah, I think it was very good received, short forehand, and that allowed him to get the first attack. And yeah, first 2 points very strong coming out from Tanaka. I think generally Tanaka will try to employ serving more to the short forehand. Usually, normally the Chinese, normally they're not so strong with the forehand flick as they are with the backhand, so maybe Tanaka will try to use this more.
Well, and Kanak Jha is sitting here and he's amazed. You know that is some good table tennis.
Wow, that was unbelievable point. You can really see the speed of both players is just mind-boggling. It's unbelievable. Tanaka started really well this match, I have to say. I think it's really important for the Japanese to get a good start in each match to put the Chinese a little under more pressure. Because once the Chinese gets relaxed, it can be really difficult to beat them.
So Yu on the board, finally. Geez, but Tanaka, I mean, he's just come out so aggressively, hasn't he? He's just been over the table. He's using his angles well. Yu obviously will come back a little bit here, but he just needs to tie him up more.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, right now Tanaka is, you can see he's been really preparing for this match. He's had no problems with the serve receive. He knows what to serve and what to expect on UAE's receive. So, yeah, just a perfect start from him, really. 6-1 up now.
Can't prepare for that, though.
No, just a little lucky from UAE, but I think normally in the match it evens out both ways for the players.
So not worth complaining, you think?
No, I don't think so. I think best scenario is just to brush it off and focus on the next point.
So again, they're Tanaka trying the aggressive return, not quite making it, but
this one, I think, clipped the edge, actually.
Clipped the edge. Yeah. Wow, sorry. You've got better eyes than me. So, for you, what does he need to do here? Do you think it's just about starting to take the aggression away from Tanaka? How's he going to stop him?
Well, actually, right now it's a little hard to say. Tanaka's made very few mistakes, but I think also
Yuahi will slowly adjust to Tanaka's style. I think it's the first time they played each other. And as Yuahi gets more and more comfortable with the style, I think you'll see him to start playing better and better.
Beautiful short return. Bit of a change up of a serve there.
Yeah, he tried serving the side spin hook service more to short forehand, but still a very short receive by UAE. Oof, wow. The Japanese have taken a timeout now. It's quite interesting to take it in the first set, but also in a best of five, the first set is very important. Also, to take the first set is a great mentally boost for confidence, especially against the Chinese, to put them under pressure. So I think it is a good decision.
Yes, it is interesting at the first game. I mean, you know, if you came in off the street and you saw that you're leading 9-7 in the first game, you know, you think, why on earth would you take a timeout? But it just, Tanaka came out so aggressively, so fast, and he just needs to make sure that he closes out this first game. If comes up and wins this, it'll be pretty devastating for Tanaka and for the Japanese team, I think.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, not just from having a big lead, losing it in the first set, also mentally to know, going into the second set, man, I should have won this first set. This can be also a little challenging. So I think it was a good timeout, and we'll see now if it'll pay off.
That's it. You up to the task again. Tanaka trying to be aggressive, but the serve was good. I mean, Tanaka couldn't really get a lot of pace on the return. It's a let.
Amazing flick by Tanaka. Takes a lot of guts to go down the line to the forehand, especially where the Chinese are strongest, but there he made the right decision. UAE was completely stepped around and had no chance.
And that earns him 2 game points. 10-8. And there it is, first game to Tanaka. 11 points to 8, and Japan off to a booming start. So you see there, Kanak, that you know, Japan very positive, obviously, after the first game, and Tanaka was so aggressive early, landed everything, but you certainly, the second half was much stronger.
Yeah, I was really impressed in the beginning of the set how strong Tanaka started out. He came out the first 5 balls just flying both sides, very tight receives. But I think it's very hard to maintain that level for a full match, especially against the Chinese, where if you even lose a little bit focus, they can really come out and attack on all sides. So we can see now if Tanaka can keep going or start to slow down a little bit.
So can I? You're talking about, you know, I mean, the Chinese as a collective, and it's a bit of that, just that mental pressure of playing China to start off with, right? I mean, forget about the player that you're playing, but it's just playing China.
Yeah, it does definitely affect you a little bit. I mean, knowing you're playing China, the best country in the world, you always have a little bit more respect for them. And yeah.
So players now ready for the second game. Tanaka leading one game to love. Well, that ball slipping the net and going wide. So love one.
So it was a nice flip by Yuehi to the middle of Tanaka. So very good placement.
So that serve is serving at short to the forehand of Tanaka, and Tanaka's not able to get as much. Has he changed something there?
I think right now Tanaka's trying to flick a lot on the receive, and serving the short forehand, you have to come in a lot more to have a good position for a flick, so it's a good placement from UAE on the service.
That time Tanaka aggressive with the block. It's not really a block, right? It's counter spin, it's...
Yeah, it's more kind of like an active block where not trying to be too passive.
You just holding him up there.
Little clip off the net.
Yeah, so the mood's definitely changed here in this second game. I mean, Tanaka made a couple of errors early in the game. You just getting a little bit of luck off the top of the net.
Yeah, for sure. It's not the as strong start, but the set started off still very close. Normally just 1-2 point difference. So we'll see if it'll stay close throughout the set.
Fantastic return there. I mean, sitting here, it looks pretty easy, you know. But returning these guys' serves, what are you trying to look for? What are you seeing on their serve?
I think service return and service, really, when you get to a higher level, is one of the most important parts of the game. It's not only reading the spin properly, of course, they have great services, but also knowing you have to have a very high quality receives in order that they cannot attack the next ball. So normally, players try to push short or have an aggressive flick in order to be starting actively in the rally and not in the passive mode.
So give me your thoughts. I mean, in the game, I mean, if you can put it, we'll just have a look at this rally.
Nice service.
If you can put it in percentages, you know, how important is the serve and return of serve compared to having a good forehand and backhand, say?
I think, of course, every point starts off with the service and the return, so service is, I would say, maybe the most important part of the game. Even if you have a strong forehand, a strong backhand, you can't get into the point to use that forehand if you don't have a serve to set it up. So really, service and receive is so important, especially when you get to this level.
So Tanaka serving now, 5-7. Let's see what he can do. So good little side spin serve. Got the ball he wanted, or he saw that next ball pretty well and crunched the forehand. 1 point in it. Oh.
Amazing flick by Tanaka. Just over the table, fully invested in it, and just won the point outright.
And Yu's return was high, but it's not really high. I mean, it's a couple of centimeters higher.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, for them, even a couple centimeters a little bit not as deep or not a little bit higher, this can make the difference in the points. So every part of the game really matters so much at this level.
You getting quite vocal now. Trying to stamp his authority mentally, physically.
Very good change of placement on Tanaka's serve, going to a wide backhand, I think for the first time this set.
Wow, wow. That is so aggressive on this backhand here.
Yeah, I mean, just the speed is incredible. I mean, he was ready for the backhand loop from UAE and just went over the ball and finished the point.
And that placement was good too, just a little bit more middle to the forehand. You was looking for the backhand area.
Great rally.
And like that, Tanaka now goes to game point. So this has been a big turnaround in the last few points by Tanaka. 10-9. But you said, no, 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 not just yet.
Yeah, it was actually a little bit risky from you to serve long, especially at 9-10, but he caught Tanaka off guard and managed to get a strong four on you.
So now you with a game point. Trying to level this up. And there it is. Game two to Yu of China. 12-10. So the game match now standing at one game all. Tanaka 11-8. Yu 12-10.
Well, I must say, really, it was really important for UAE, for his confidence to take this set. To go 2-0 down would have been really tough for him. And he saved a game set ball at 9-10 with a long service. That can really show he's willing to take risks in the match. And now it's 1-1 and it's back to all square. So
I mean, we talked about technical, but I mean, mentally, I mean, is this the difference? You know, again, you talked about playing China. Is it difficult in this situation to close out those important points?
Yeah, for sure. I think, especially when it gets closer, you start to overthink a little bit more. You can also be thinking, wow, I'm 1 point away from taking the second set against the Chinese. So it definitely is much harder to win the last point, I'd say, in the beginning. And that's why I think the Chinese are generally so strong when it comes to close situations.
So now players have had their 1 minute break. You taking that close second game, jumping around, getting active, and serving. Again, long serve, and ready for that return.
Yeah, you can see UAE, he's really now getting his forehand more and more into the match, and stepping around right after the service.
Wow, such a turnaround in these last 5 or 6 points, isn't it? Tanaka had game point for 2-love, and now 1-all. You leading 2-love. Getting vocal, active, aggressive. And Tanaka right back.
Yeah.
another one.
Yes, what an amazing flick. Now he's caught Yui a few times with this flick down to the forehand. Yui stepping around quite a lot, I have to say, after the service, so it's good from Tanaka to not to change the placement up just so he's not so comfortable.
Went there again, but he wasn't having any of that.
This time he was ready.
I mean, easy in hindsight, but you know, should Tanaka have changed the position of that return?
Yes, maybe. Of course, it's hard to at the moment to say, but yeah, I think sometimes going two times to the same place, the player can be ready a second time.
You're just so strong over the table here. Look at him, just.
Yeah, you can see now as the match is going on, UAE is becoming more and more aggressive, especially with that forehand. So it's going to be hard now to Tanaka to find a way for him to make the rallies and win the points.
So a good change up again of the serve, you know, coming around the right-hand side of the ball that time on the serve, and you just really popped that up. You didn't like it at all, didn't like the change at all.
Yes, it was a good change of serve from Tanaka. UAE again serving the long serve. I think it's interesting to see how much Tanaka is coming in for the backhand flick always. Not really going for a short return.
Yeah, so he's just really staying away from that position there where Tanaka can come in and make that backhand flick. You know, short serving long, short to the forehand a little bit more.
Yes. I think one thing I've really noticed this set is the difference of the receives. I mean, Tanaka is trying to receive everything with flick, changing the placement, but now UAE is ready for it, while Yu, on the other hand, is trying to receive more short so he can get the first attack.
And I think that's a simple thing that a lot of players miss, isn't it, Kanak? I mean, that short return can be so effective. I mean, often players are trying to do too much or too aggressive and using the flick too much.
Yeah, I think now, I mean, we live in 2018 where everyone is employing the backhand banana. All players, especially younger kids, are learning at a young age, but I think the short puts.
Yeah, sorry. And so you just closing out game three, 11-3 to take a 2-1 lead. So, yes, Kanak, you were saying the flick?
Yeah, I mean, now in this era of table tennis, like I said, everyone is employing the backhand flick over the table, especially the Asians. But I think also the short is something that's really important in this sport. I mean, when you play the ball short with good placement, it's really hard to do anything back. And you can see UAE is now receiving a lot with forehand short, and this is giving him the chance to always manage to start first in the rally.
And for me, that's actually an area that the Chinese are dominant. I think the Chinese short return of serve is so good. And I think it's just an area that we tend to miss a lot. We'd like to see the banana flicks and the strawberry flicks that are happening. But the Chinese are just so strong with that short return. So now Tanaka will be looking to try to gain that dominance again that he had early in this match. You know, he was up a game point to go 2-0, but now finds himself down 2-1, and the players now coming out to ready for the fourth game with Tanaka serving down 2-1.
I think Tanaka is maybe will try employing this hook service of his more. I mean, UAE is struggling to keep it short and keep it low on the receive, so I think it's right now working very well for him.
Yeah, and he served that one to the back end. He served a couple to the forehand previously. Yu is pumped.
See, Tanaka really struggling with the reverse service. I mean, I think the coach, maybe he's trying to change more with receiving more to push, but hard to control the spin.
So a few reverse serves there that are really troubling Tanaka now. And boy, isn't you loving this. That's the serve we want him to use, but Yu was ready for that and over the top of it. Maybe just getting used to that a little bit?
Yeah, but actually I think this was the first time Yu came to flick the hook service from Tanaka. So you can see he adjusted to the serve. Now Tanaka... very strong. I think maybe when Tanaka's serving his hook serve, you can see UAE's having problems when he's pushing, keeping it short. So I think now, if UAE tries to come in more to flick, it wouldn't be a bad idea for Tanaka to maybe serve just one long, just so UAE is not coming in too early with the flick.
Big angle there.
So started off a deep push to forehand, and then a wide block to the backhand. Wow.
Even the footwork of Yu couldn't get there. Yeah, I think you'll be disappointed with that. I think he got the ball he wanted. You know, it wasn't a strong flick there by Tanaka. So four all.
Tough mistake from Tanaka, but was the ball he wanted for sure. Again, Yu couldn't keep the hook service low, and Tanaka just a little bit overhitting it there.
He seems to be serving with a bit of top all the time on the hook serve, but Yu's not seeing it.
That's just unbelievable power from UAE. I mean, it was a good flick, but once UAE managed to get that first forehand in, if it doesn't win the point directly, he'll play the next one also with four, and it's very hard to stop him then.
So you ranked number 10 currently in the world. I'm sitting next to the number one ranked player in the world, Kanak Jha from the USA.
Wow. That's second push by Tanaka to the wide forehand and then blocking to the back end. Good change of receive, I have to say. I mean, it's always a risk when you push long to the player's forehand, but both times he caught UAE off guard and won the point.
So he went the traditional pendulum on the left-hand side of the ball. He's had success with the hook. Yeah. So Yu's starting to flick that return, the hook serve now. So yeah, I think you know Tanaka just needs to change that up again, especially not too much short. Yu's getting over the top of that. Tough to know where to serve to Yu in this frame of mind.
Yeah, I think now UAE is more comfortable to receive. I still think the hook serve is the way to go, especially even when UAE is flicking with the forehand. It's not a very aggressive flick, so wow. But if Tanaka can try to be more active on his third ball after his service, I think that would help him. especially maybe even turning around one or two times to attack the deforehand after a serve.
And that was a much more aggressive return too by Tanaka. You got over the top of that ball better, didn't really lift so much. So that ball flying way out of court, and Yu's gone to get it. A little bit of time for both players to think.
Well, now it's leveled back up at 8-8 with Tanaka's serve. I think now it's hopefully a good chance to maybe take one, maybe 2 points on his serve would be really great for Tanaka.
So what does he do here, Kanak? Where does he go?
I think Tanaka must probably just be ready for the flick on the receive and try to be active on this third ball. You can see when UAE flicks it with his forehand, it's not an aggressive flick, just very good placement, always to the middle. So Tanaka is not ready to play a full power shot on it.
Yeah, it almost seems like he could play a little bit stronger, but just a bit tentative with it.
Yes.
Oh, that's a costly mistake, that.
Yes, 10-8 now. Two match balls for UAE with the service. I think he's in a very good position right now to close out the match with one of these 2 points, with this with his service.
And there it is, match to UAE, 3-1.
Wow.
8-11, 12-10, 11-3, 11-8.
It was a great match to watch. I have to say, the speed is just amazing from both of these two players. But I think it was a very great start from Tanaka. He had won the first set, second set had a great chance. But after UAE, just started playing more and more better and showed his true level.
Yes, it certainly was impressive by you. I mean, you're right there. He was in a position to go down 2-0, but he was strong, took that second game, and then just really powered through and took the match for China to set them up and winning the first match of this World Junior Boys Teams Final. And a big thank you to Kanak Jha, the number one ranked player in the world in this Junior Boys division. Absolute privilege to have you here in the commentary box, and thank you very much for your insights.
Yes, thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of the match, guys. I think it'll be really exciting, and I hope you enjoyed the commentating.